Welcome to lab 5 of day 1. In this video, we will try to understand how we can use if conditions or conditional statements in C#. Now let's take the scenario here. Let's take the same application, you know, which we have been discussing from lab 2, lab 3 and lab 4. Now let's say that, the statement, you know, where we are taking the name of the user, right? We want that the name of the user should be restricted to 10 length. In other words, if somebody puts a username which is, or the name, you know, which is more than 10 characters, you know, we should throw up exception saying that please ensure that your username is less than 10 characters. So how do we do that in C#? So for doing the same, we have a conditional statement called as if. So what we can do is, you know, whatever data is entered into the string here, we can say if some data from user dot length, if it is greater than 10, then please show a message here. console.writeLine username or name, I'll say, should not be greater than 10 characters. So let's do a control F5 now. So now if I put more than 10 characters, let's say if I put shiv, it works fine. Good. Now let me go and put more than 10 characters. I have a big name, so this is Shivprasad Koirala, and now you can see that basically it has shown me the message saying that name should not be greater than 10 characters, right? And it's working perfectly well. But there's a problem here. The problem is that it has shown me the error, but it is still executing the application ahead. You can see that it has gone ahead and executed this line, enter your age, which we don't want, right? What we want is, we want him to show the error, and after that, you know, the application should just exit. So again, we have to cleverly use our try-catch statement. So let me just close this application here. Now one is that you can use the try-catch statement. The other one is, what you can do is you can just say your return. If you use the return statement, what happens is, you know, as soon as, you know, he displays this error message here, after that, from here, you know, the application just exits and comes out. It does not go ahead and execute the other lines of code here. So one is that you can use the return statement. Let's first demonstrate by return statement, and then we will demonstrate by using the try and catch block. So now if I go and put more than 10 characters, you can see that it says name should not be greater than 10 characters, and after that the application just closes, right? So one way is to use the return statement, and the other proper way is by using the try catch block. So let's go and delete this return statement from here, and now let's put a try block here. Put this whole thing into a try block, right? And now what you can do is, you can say here, as soon as you get this error, you know, say that throw exception. So you'll say throw new exception, right? So what will happen now here is that as soon as, you know, the data goes above the 10 characters, it will throw up exception, and straightforward from here the control will come into this catch here. And here what we can do is, we can say here, please display the exception message. So ex.message.toString, right? So in other words, as soon as you find that, you know, this what you call variable is more than 10 length, he will throw up exception. From here the control will not go here, it will straightforward come to the exception and display the exception. Okay, so now let me go and run this application here. So I'll say control F5, and now if I put proper things, it will work nice. Now if I put abnormal things, that is more than 10 characters, so let me again do a control F5. Now if I say something like this, you can see now, you know, from here, right, when this exception was thrown, straightforward, you know, that exception came into this catch block and it was displayed, and after that, you know, the application just exited. So I hope that you enjoyed this lab. In this lab, you know, we try to understand two things. One is that how to use if conditions, and then how to use if conditions, you know, with the return statement, and how to use if conditions with try and catch. So I hope that you enjoyed this lab, and see you in the coming up labs. Thank you very much. Now whatever video you have seen, right, is just a glimpse of what we have done. So in case you are interested in our video package, you can go to our site, that is www.questpond.com. You can call on this number and you can ask the complete DVD package what we have. So in this DVD package, what we have done is basically we have covered almost everything what a .NET developer wants. So right from basics of ASP.NET, object-oriented programming, SQL Server, to new technologies like WCF, Silverlight, Link, Azure, Entity Framework. We also have UML, architecture, estimation, project management. There is a complete invoicing project end-to-end which is covered so that you can get a better feel of how to actually create projects in a systematic manner. We have covered server products, you know, both for SharePoint 2007 as well as for 2010. We have a lot of best practices video on SQL Server, etc. So this complete package, you know, you can get from www.quespon.com if you're interested. And you can call on this number and you can ask for the rates. It's a very decent rate what we have. In the same way, you know, as compared to the videos, we also have one more product with us, that is our interview question books. So we have different kinds of interview question books, you know, right from .NET interview questions to SQL Server interview questions, SharePoint interview questions, BizTalk interview questions, etc. So in case you are interested in the books part, you can call on these numbers as per your location. So you can see these numbers on the board at this moment. So I hope that you keep enjoying the videos, you keep seeing our site, and I hope that you gain more knowledge. Thank you very much.